Well, hello, everybody. I'm here with Martha. She is from Windsor, Ontario, and I've been working with Martha for a couple of years now. And I guess the first thing that people always want to know, Martha, is a story about how you got started gardening. What was it that led to you saying, I have to go out there and grow some food?
I was in a high rise in Toronto, and I had a very large balcony that faced south. So I made myself like a form and put boxes on that. And my garden was 1 foot by 21 feet.
That's awesome.
I grew what I could there. And I had a lot of encouragement from my brother, who called this urban farming, and he would take pictures. And I just tried to grow something for a long time, but it was much more recent. Oh yes, and I adopted a couple of kids, and we got a plot because we were living in an apartment. We got a city plot and farmed that. And I remember my mom asking me, well, is it worth it? I think from the middle of May to the end of October, it cost me $40. And I was so surprised at her question, because they provided water as well. And I said, how do you measure things like being out in the open, teaching children about where the food is coming from, so that they can see how seeds are growing and they can see what things they want to eat? And I said, I don't know how to measure those things. Maybe we don't get $40 worth of food out of this. But then when I retired, I moved down to Windsor, which is my hometown, and started in more seriously, really trying to grow stuff that we can use throughout the year.
That's amazing. I think, and that's a question that a lot of people have, is it worth it to grow food? Because they see it as a different lifestyle than they currently have, and it's going to be another amount of, quote, work put on their daily routine. Mm-hmm. So for those people who maybe are out there thinking, oh man, I got another thing on my to-do list, do you think it's worth it?
Oh, I definitely do, and especially if you have children. I have two plots right next to each other, and my daughter and granddaughter live in the one. And we grow mostly in that yard because it's sunnier than mine that's right next door. And my little granddaughter, even when she was two, she knew where the carrots were, and she would go out there and just pull one up and eat it. And there's so much nicer tasting. And you could just, she has her own little special plot, and she grows tomatoes and cucumbers and things that she wants to grow. And I definitely think things taste better, and you can just walk out the door and get what you want out of the garden.
It's amazing, right?
Yeah.
Another thing that's interesting about what you said is that you got started in a small plot, a 1 foot strip, because that's what was available. So I think that for wherever people are, you know, use the available space. And then you did an amazing thing, which is you went out and found more space. You said, hey, let's go do this. So I think that's a really great way to increase the amount of food that you can grow, is just go find some space. It's actually easier than you think. How long did it take you to find that space to grow?
Actually, it was a friend who lived in my building, a plot became available. She had a plot, and she said, oh, come and join me. And so that's how I got started on that one. It was just grass when I came here. So each year I've been trying to reclaim a little bit more of it. Mm-hmm. And I think the thing that really impressed me about my first course that I took with you was the planning. That, okay, plan where your tomatoes will be year one, and then year two, and then year three, and it will just make everything so much easier. And I have the very back part of the yard I've tried to make into a pollinator patch. But boy, does it get wild by the end of the summer. So this year I'm thinking maybe to put squash back there and let them crowd out some of the other stuff so that I don't get too many complaints from neighbors.
That's great. So you mentioned that the planning is something that has helped in your garden. What do you see as some of the benefits that you've seen in your garden in the last couple of years? What other kinds of things have you put into place that have helped you have more success or do things differently? Or what have you noticed?
Certainly, last year I tried a lot of the harvesting recipes and things like that. And your whole idea of setting up a structure of, you know, where are you going to wash them? Where are you going to put them when you take them into your kitchen and so on? So that kind of thing has been helpful. And I would like to chart them better. How much I get each day and so on. So it's not that I didn't have any harvest. I did. I had some good harvest. Eggplant was very good. Tomato was okay. Cayenne was fine.
Lots
of herbs. And using the weeds, I'm trying to learn about the medicinal value of some of the weeds that are around and things
awesome.
Like
that. So, Yeah, those are the bonus crops. Those are the things that you didn't even plan on that you get to eat.
Oh, I thought the plantain was such an ugly plant. And now that I know it, some of the things you can do with it, it's really changed my perspective on it.
Yeah, what have you done anything with the plantain?
I dried some. I've dried some and have it ready to use. And I have chamomile and I've used it as teas, but then I used it more recently. I'm making a salve for my granddaughter who had a bad itch. So, you know, I'm just beginning in those things.
So you've come this far. What advice would you give to somebody who's just getting started and who wants to grow some food, specifically vegetables and herbs?
I would say just start with one or two. Think of what you really like and start with those. Like my daughter, about the only thing she likes to do in the garden is the harvesting. And she really likes the tomatoes. So we plant tomatoes and she'll go out and get those. So find something that you really like to eat and start with that.
Yeah. Is there something that's gotten easier over the years for you? Something that used to be hard that now seems much easier?
Just the enjoyment of being out there and the planting and choosing different things and then seeing the ones that you really like and doing those again.
Mm-hmm. When you say enjoyment, I'm curious if you mean, I don't know about you, but when I first got started, I used to run around like a crazy lady and I didn't really enjoy my time outside. And now now it feels more comfortable. Is that what you mean by enjoyment? Or do you mean the actual enjoyment of the food, that you enjoy the food more?
Both. I really like being outside. And because I'm retired, you know, I don't have to watch my time quite so carefully.
Yeah.
And so I can just go out, enjoy the sunshine. I really like the early spring before the bugs get really going.
Right.
And when it gets really, really hot, then I go out early. And setting up a watering system was last year's big thing, and that was very helpful.
How did that go? What kind of resources did you use, or what did you learn in that process?
I got a hose system that the small hose just leaks the water out, and I found that you really have to check it. It doesn't go evenly all the way, so you have to watch the plants and where they're not doing so well, see if it's the water not getting through.
Is there anything that you wanted to add about why is it worth it to grow food, or anything you wanted to add in general about your experience these last couple of years growing food?
I just think being out, being with your hands in the dirt, it just feels, for me, it just feels really good. and being in the sunshine and watching how things change, watching the flowers and then finding the seeds. Like by mistake, some carrots went to seed last year. I had no idea what their seeds looked like, and there's Queen Anne's lace around, and my goodness, is this weed got in my garden? No, it was carrots. And you know, just those kind of discoveries are, I find, really exciting. And then trying to learn how to harvest the seeds, and there's just such a lot to do and be part of out there.
Yeah. Do you think you'll garden for the rest of your life?
When I came and I started this big project, my mom was still living, and she said, you're crazy. You won't be able to do this. And I said, I don't care if I just get 5 more years, that would be fine. So as long as I can do it, I would like to do it.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, thank you so much for spending this time with us. And I'm sure that people are going to be inspired by your story. Thanks so much, Martha.
Thank you.